Thank you for tuning in to our very first episode of Flat Hats at Home, bringing a little slice of Redwood National and State Parks to you and your home. My name is Ranger Allie, and I'm actually working from home right now in my makeshift home office. Now, on our first episode, we're going to talk about something that's a little surprising, it really beats the odds, and it might even blow your mind. Redwood cones and seeds. Redwoods are the tallest trees in the entire world, so they have to have big cones, right? Well, think again. Redwood cones are super tiny, only about the size of an olive. Now, I don't have an olive, but I do have a tomato, just to give you a little bit of a size reference. And speaking of tomatoes, the redwood seed, which lives inside of the cone and actually produces the redwood sapling, is only about the size of a tomato seed. So super itty bitty. But wait, it gets even crazier. So each one of these cones produces about 60 seeds or so. And each tree produces about 100,000 seeds every year. So to represent this, each one of these grains of rice represents one seed. That's a lot of seeds. But wait. Only about 3% of these seeds are actually viable or able to grow. So of all of these seeds, only about this many could maybe produce a little tiny redwood. Only about 10% of the ones that are viable will actually be able to land and maybe produce a little sapling. A lot of them will be eaten. Maybe they'll be eaten by a squirrel. Maybe they'll land on a fern or a rock and not be even able to sprout. But some of them will, and they'll produce a little baby redwood. Now, only about 1% of those will actually be able to produce a mature redwood. A lot of these seedlings won't survive. They will maybe not have enough sunlight, not have enough water, not have enough nutrients in the soil. Maybe they'll get eaten by a passing animal. Who knows? But at the end of the day, only about 1% of those seedlings might make it to be a mature redwood. So the probability of one of these cones producing a seed that could become a mature redwood is super, 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 super small. So although the odds might be small, it just takes one seed coming from a baby cone to produce a tree that could be hundreds, even thousands of years old, or grow to be over 350 feet tall. That's taller than the Statue of Liberty. So these things really do beat the odds. Come back next week to learn a little bit more about how redwoods reproduce. I promise you will be amazed. Hint, hint, it doesn't even use seeds. Thank you so much for tuning in to our very first episode of Flat Hats at Home. My name is Ranger Allie, bringing you a little slice of redwood from our park to your home. If you enjoyed this video and learned something new, give us a like or give us a share. Redwood National and State Parks is committed to bringing our park to as many homes as we can during this unprecedented time. So thanks for watching, stay healthy, and stay safe.